Hi guys, this is Avinash Sharma, and in this session we will discuss the how to create the new record and how to modify the existing data using the patch and the submit form. And first of all, we check the submit form. Later on, we will check what is the difference between the patch and the submit form. The submit form, it's easier comparatively to the patch function. When we want to submit the data form to our data source, then we can use the submit form. Submit form in command, and just we need to supply the name of the form. So we check practically. So first of all, we check the practical of the submit form with the Google Sheet. And we have a Google Sheet, name is the employee sheet, and then employee data, sheet name. In this field, we have the four fields, ID, name, city, and mobile number. Now, if we check our design, so already we have designed the form. In this form, we have a label, that is the employee data, and then card. The first one is the employee ID. If we check in the left side, so I have renamed all the fields. This is the EMP ID, name, this is the EMP name, and then EMP city, and EMP mobile number. So this is my naming convention standard. Accordingly, yeah, like your according your standard, you can name the labels or fields. And next we have the button. Button for the button, I have renamed this one BTN add data, because according the type of the control, it's a button type. So I am prefixing the BTN. And for the label, I add the LB. So it's a button, BTN add data. Then we have a label, status, and another label. Name of this label is the LB status. This label we would be using for the displaying the status of the data submission. It means whenever the form is submitted. So whether the form is submitted successfully or not, if there is an error, then we can display that error in this label. Now we write the code for the submission of the form. First of all, we take the label and the text property of this label, because we are using this label for displaying the status of the form. So whenever the form is submitted, there is a property of the form, is an error property. If the form is submitted successfully, then that property, error property, is blank, and if there is an error, then message is filled with that property. So we can check that property is blank or not. So if is blank, then form employee dot error property. If this property is blank, it means no error. So we can say data added successfully. And else part of the if, then we need to display the actual information, and that information is in the error property of the form. So form employee dot error. So this is done. Now add button. First of all, submit, then employee form. So this command will store the data, will take the data from the form and save in your Google Sheet. Now semicolon. Suppose if you want to write the multiple commands, then when we must use the semicolon. So what we do now, we want to display some information on the top of the form, whether the form has been submitted successfully or not. So it's a notify. Notify, and again if is blank, then form dot error, then form submitted successfully. Otherwise, else part of the if statement. So we can display the actual information. So form employee and dot say error. Now whenever the form is submitted, the mode of the form is changed to the view mode. What we want? We want after submission of the form, we want the form in the again the new form mode. So we can write here new form and then from employee. So these are the multiple statements. So if we need the multiple statement, then we must put the semicolon and at the end of the statement. Now we check the form. So ID say 100, name Smith, city say London, then mobile number. Add data, so we can see the error on the top and error in the label. Server response error, too many requests sent to the Google Sheet. Okay, so we should wait for few seconds. We try again. Now on the top we can see form submitted successfully, and even you can see in the label data added successfully. Now we check the Google Sheet. And Google Sheet, now we have the data. ID 100, name Smith, city London, and this is a mobile number. And this is the ID generated by the Power App. Basically, this ID is generated for each and every row in the Google Sheet. This is the unique identification for each row. Whenever you update the data, so the Power App update the data on the basis of this unique ID. So this is how you can use the submit form for adding the data in Google Sheet or SharePoint. Now we check the patch. So already we discussed the submit form. Now how to add the new record with the patch? Using the patch, we can add the new record, we can modify the records, we can add the multiple records, and we can modify the multiple records. So as you can see in the syntax, we have the data source that is the required. So in which data source you want to modify or create the records, then the base records, you have to mention the details of the records, and if you're adding the new record, then you can use the default this way. And the third one is the new records. The records to be modified, the information of the record you can mention here. Now we check how to add the new record with the patch. So we take button. And then patch add data, and on select, then patch bracket. This is the data source name. Now defaults, because we are adding or we are creating a new record, so that's why we are using the defaults. Again source name, then comma, curly brackets, and again closing brackets. Now within this curly brackets we have to supply the parameters. Okay, first of all, if I start typing ID, so you can see we have the list of the fields which are available in the list. So ID with colon, then so already we renamed the all the fields, say EMP, then ID dot text, then second one say name and EMP name dot text and comma mobile number, then EMP mobile number dot text, and finally city, then EMP city dot text. So this is done. Now we test this one. So first of all we check our Google Sheet. In Google Sheet we have the records up to the 102. Now say 103 name Johnson, mobile number say 333, and city again Delhi. Now click patch add data. This is done. Now we check the Google Sheet. So we have the 103 Johnson Delhi, and this is a mobile number. Now how to update the record using the patch function? So we have taken the two skin. On first skin we have the gallery. In gallery we display all the records which we entered previously. Now on the second skin we have the edit form. So now on edit form button, and then patch update, and on select property say patch, then source data source and lookup. So this time we are using the lookup. The lookup function will retrieve the particular records on the basis of the parameter we supply. So again employee data comma, and we will search the records on the basis of the ID. So ID equal to EMP ID, so we will take the value from the text box dot text. Now again in the brackets we have to supply the number. We can supply all the fields or selected fields. Suppose we want to change only the name, then name and EMP say name dot text, then bracket close. So this is done. Now so in the patch we are searching the record on the basis of the ID, and the ID is coming from the text box, and then we are changing only the name, so not all fields. So we check this one. Now say Johnson, suppose select this one, and now we have the Johnson. So we change this one, Johnson Kim. So if we change the other value, so there is no impact in the database, because in the patch function we are changing the value only for the name. So patch update. Now we check the value for this 103 ID in the Google sheet. So 103, it says Johnson came. So guys, this was all about the how to create and update the records using the submit form and the patch function. Thanks for watching the video.